Christmas is just around the corner and there are a lot of people looking to buy a new iPhone, like the iPhone 13 Pro Max, which I currently own and I absolutely love. But if you're someone who only upgrades their iPhone every 2, 3, or 4 years, you might actually want to hold off for just another 9 months because the leaks for the new iPhone 14 models are pointing to some of the biggest changes we've seen in years, especially in terms of the design, the cameras, and the new chip. So let's get right into it. So the first thing we've got to start off is the iPhone 14 lineup and which models are going to be sold. And luckily we have this awesome source, Ross Young, who is a display analyst, and he currently has a 100% accuracy rating, and he totally nailed the MacBook Pro display with ProMotion and the iPad mini 6 display, so I fully trust him. He is saying that next year in 2022, we are going to be having 4 iPhone models. We're gonna have the regular 6.1 inch iPhone 14, just like the current iPhone 13, and then we're gonna have the iPhone 14 Pro, which is all the same, but this year we're getting something totally new. We are getting an iPhone 14 Max with the same 6.7 inch display as the current 13 Pro Max. So that is something totally new, and it's gonna allow you to get the larger display at a lower price without having to go up to the iPhone 14 Pro Max model with all of the extra pro features. And the big difference this year is that there is no longer going to be an iPhone 14 mini model, so that's going to be huge. But keep in mind that there's a good chance that the iPhone 13 mini is going to still be sold, so if you want that mini, you're still going to have that option, but not with any of the iPhone 14 changes. So with that said, we're basically getting 4 new iPhone 14 models, 2 with a 6.1 inch display, and then 2 with a 6.7 inch display. But the big question is, how is Apple going to differentiate the Pro models and which features are going to be exclusive to them? Well, first of all, if you take a close look at this chart, you'll see that both the Pro models right there and right there, they actually are going to come with 120 Hz ProMotion technology like the current iPhone 13 Pro models have. So it's basically going to be the same deal as it is now next year, just as we can see in this report from the ELEC, claiming that at least one iPhone 14 model is going to be sticking with a regular 16 Hz display and not getting the 120. But other than ProMotion, if you take a look at all the resolutions and the technologies and the PPI, you're getting essentially the same display except for 120 Hz on the Pro. And now I know that in-display Touch ID has been rumored for many years, but unfortunately, according to Ming-Chi Kuo, it's getting delayed again, so we're not getting in-display Touch ID at least until 2023. And now the big question we have to answer is, how in the world are you supposed to tell if somebody has a regular 14 or a 14 Pro model, especially with that new larger max display size? Well, we now have the full redesign that Jon Prosser showed us back on September 8th before the iPhone 13 was revealed. And here you go, we can look at these images. And as you can see, the new iPhone 14 Pro models are gonna have a hole punch display. That's how you're gonna tell if you have a Pro model or a regular model, because I'm personally expecting the regular models to still have the same exact notch, just like we have on the iPhone 13. And in case you're having a hard time believing that, Ming-Chi Kuo came out and said that Apple's finally ditching the notch for a hole punch display on the iPhone 14 Pro. Yes, that's the Pro, not the regular models. And going even further, we got even more leaks from a Korean Weibo account saying that we're getting a 120 Hz hole punch display for the 14 Pro. But other than the display changes, we are expecting a full redesign, which Jon Prosser showed off, and this is radically different. First of all, you can see that the back glass is completely flush, getting rid of that glass camera bump that we have on the current iPhones. But the crazy thing is that the glass actually protrudes away from the frame compared to the current iPhone 13 and 13 Pro design, where the glass is within the metal chassis. So that's a huge update. And on top of that, he's also expecting the display glass to protrude just like the back glass, which is definitely sketchy if you drop it and crack it. But what this is gonna do is it's gonna give you a thinner frame, which is gonna look and feel more premium. And if you're worried about the frame bending or anything like that, we are expecting the iPhone 14 Pro models to come with a tough titanium alloy chassis, as you can see right here. So it's gonna be basically more strong. But if you are getting the iPhone 14 model, that's probably gonna stick to the regular aluminum, which sucks, but that's all right. And as far as having the front glass protruding away from the frame, this is actually gonna give Apple an advantage of having more internal space, since they don't need to have the glass within that chassis. So they could potentially increase the battery size, or of course, just make it thinner. But with that said, we are also expecting some other design changes, like apparently getting circular volume buttons, which is totally new, and I'm not sure if that's right or not. But we are getting a redesign for the speaker grills, as you can see right here on the bottom. And I've got to say, that looks pretty unique. And to Jon's credit, Mark Gurman actually came out at the end of September and said that the iPhone 14 is getting a complete redesign, so I personally think that Jon is right on this one. But the only thing that I don't agree with is that Jon shows the camera bumps actually being completely flush with the back glass, and I don't think that it's gonna be like this, because first of all, the camera bump on the current iPhone 13 Pro is massive. It sticks out like crazy, and I think this is gonna be impossible for Apple to do because it's just gonna be so thick. I personally think it's gonna look more like this render from Constantine, where the glass is completely flush, but the camera bumps are protruding, which I think looks more premium, and I think it is more realistic, especially because of this next insane leak. Back in April, Meng-Shi Kuo gave us a massive camera leak claiming that the high-end iPhone 14 Pro models will be getting a 48 megapixel camera, which is basically 4 times more pixels than the current 12 megapixel cameras we have on our iPhones. Now, this is an absolutely huge deal because every single iPhone since the iPhone 6S has come with a 12 megapixel camera sensor. So we're finally getting a massive upgrade, especially since Meng-Shi Kuo said that we're getting 8K video recording, which is gonna be a game changer because Apple is gonna do it right, unlike some of the other Android smartphones that have terrible 8K quality. But in terms of photography, that 48 megapixel sensor is gonna give you incredibly sharp photos in very bright conditions. But unfortunately, having that many pixels is gonna reduce low light camera quality, so Apple is gonna have a solution, which is pixel binning. When you're gonna be shooting photos in low light conditions, the camera will be able to automatically merge sets of 4 square pixels together to essentially create pixels that are 4 times larger, which will greatly improve low light performance, but then it's gonna reduce the photo output size to the same 12 megapixel photos that we currently have today. So you're essentially getting the best of both worlds, like super sharp 48 megapixel photos for bright conditions, as you can see right here, as well as 8K video recording, but then when it's dark outside, it's gonna use pixel binning to create larger pixels with a 12 megapixel photo for better quality. Now, the only downside to 8K video recording is that it's gonna require a ton of processing power, but thankfully, Apple has been working on a solution for that, which I think they're gonna be putting into the next generation A16 Bionic chip. With the A15 chip in the iPhone 13 Pro models, Apple gave it hardware ProRes encoders and decoders. And then with the latest M1 Pro and Max chips for their Macs, Apple gave them ProRes 8K encoders and decoders. So with that said, I fully expect this new 8K recording format to use the ProRes codec, and I expect the A16 chip to come with hardware 8K ProRes encoders and decoders, which will greatly take the load off of the main CPU when recording and playing back 8K video. And that by itself could allow Apple to enable 8K 60fps recording. Yes, 60fps, which you can't get on any other smartphone in the world. Now, speaking of the A16 chip, there are a lot of questions surrounding which process node it'll be built on and how much performance it'll give us, so let's get right into that. A few months ago, it was believed that the A16 chip with the iPhone 14 would be built on TSMC's 3-nanometer node, which would be much more efficient than the current 5-nanometer node. However, it was delayed because of all of the chip shortage issues going on, and now we just got confirmation that the custom 3-nanometer chips will be delayed until 2023, as you can see right here. So because of that, it's been said that the A16 chip in the iPhone 14 will be built on the N4P process, which kind of makes it sound like it's gonna be a 4-nanometer node compared to 5, but unfortunately it's not. TSMC confirmed on their own website that N4P is actually the 3rd generation of the 5-nanometer node family. And if you didn't already know, the A14, the M1, the M1 Pro, and the M1 Max chips are built on the 1st-gen 5-nanometer node, with the new A15 chip being built on the 2nd-gen. And now, the A16 is going to be built on the 3rd-gen 5-nanometer alongside the M2 and the M2 Pro and Max chips. So this unfortunately means that TSMC is only expecting a small 6% performance boost compared to the current A15 chip, and probably around a 10% improvement in terms of power efficiency, which honestly doesn't sound like much. But don't worry, Apple has a very important trick up their sleeve, and that's the switch to the new ARMv9 architecture, which is basically the foundation of the chip. The past 10 years of Apple's chips have been built on the ARMv8 architecture, so this jump is gonna be a big one, with various benefits ranging from higher performance to better efficiency. For example, ARM is expecting a 30% performance boost at the same clock speeds over 2 generations of their chips, which basically represents a potential 14 or 15% boost just from switching to ARMv9 with a new chip design. So in reality, with all of those changes, we can easily expect Apple's A16 chip to be around 20% faster than the A15, bringing single-core performance to just over 2,000 in Geekbench 5, and multi-core performance up to around 5,500, which will make the iPhone 14 Pro almost as fast as a 2012 Mac Pro desktop. And if we apply that same performance boost to the 14,000 metal points that my iPhone 13 Pro Max is scoring, we're looking at 17,000 graphics metal points, which is almost as high as the base M1 MacBook Air. Absolute insanity. But keep in mind that with the iPhone 13 release, Apple started giving the Pro models one extra GPU core, and I have a feeling that they're going to continue this trend going forward, including giving the Pro models more RAM. So maybe with the A16 chip, they're going to give the 14 Pro models 8 gigs of RAM and the regular models 6, but I guess we're going to see. Now, before I get into answering the original question of whether it's worth waiting for the iPhone 14 or not, there are a couple of more important details to get through. First off, the iPhone 14 is expected to support Wi-Fi 6E, which includes a new 6 GHz band, which will increase the bandwidth and reduce interference. But since it's going to be more efficient, we can expect a little bit better battery life while using Wi-Fi as well. And on the 5G data side, the iPhone 14 is expected to come with Qualcomm's new X65 modem, which will improve speeds, reliability, and battery life, since it's going to be built on the 4-nanometer node from Samsung. But the big takeaway with all these leaks is that Apple is really going to be trying to push the sales of the more expensive Pro models, since the iPhone 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max are going to have exclusive features like a hole-punch camera design, a titanium chassis, an insane 48-megapixel main camera with 8K video recording, the extra telephoto camera, and finally extra RAM and GPU performance on the A16 chip. The only downside is that Apple is expected to finally raise their iPhone prices next year, but I'm personally expecting them to only do it on the Pro models, since they'll get such massive upgrades. So the regular iPhone 14 might start at the same $799, the 14 Max at $899, the 14 Pro at $1099, and the 14 Pro Max at $1199. But with all that said, should you wait for the iPhone 14 or just buy the iPhone 13 right now? Well, if you've always wanted the massive 6.7-inch display from the Pro Max models, but you were limited by your budget, you'll now be able to get it for less than $1,000. And if you're someone who only upgrades their iPhone every 3 or more years, and you would really love a notchless iPhone or that crazy camera upgrade, then I would definitely recommend waiting until next year. But if you need a new phone right now, don't wait, just buy one of the new 13s, enjoy it, and be happy. So there you guys go, hopefully you enjoy this video, and if you disagree with any of my predictions or ideas, then comment your thoughts down below. But if you enjoyed the video, go ahead and click the circle above to subscribe for more videos like this one, check out one of those two right over there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.